Mother, you don't know what sort of person I am. I don't object to crowds more than to any other curse of the men in this class. To tell you the truth, I rather admire him for being strong-minded, enough to enjoy himself in his own way and make plenty of money, instead of living the usual shooting, hunting, dining out, tailoring, laughing laugh of the sad murdering, because all the rest do it. And I'm perfectly aware that if I've been in the same circumstances as my aunt Liz, I have done exactly what she did. I don't think I'm more prejudiced or straight-laced than you. I think I'm less. I'm certain I'm less sentimental. I know very well that fashionably morality is all a pretense. And that if I took your money and devoted the rest of my life, spend it fashionably, I might be as worthless and vicious as the silliest woman that possibly wants to be without having a word said to me about it. But I don't want to be worthless. I shouldn't trotting about the park to advertise my dressmaker or carriage being there, or being bored at the opera to show off a shop window full of diamonds. Wait a moment, I'm not done. No, I am my mother's daughter. I am like you. I must have work and must make more money than I spend. But my work is not your work. And my way is not your way. We must depart. It will not make much difference to us. Perhaps, instead of meeting one another for perhaps in a few months, in 20 years, we should never meet. That's all.